So last time we have learned the mesentery, peritoneum of the abdomen. Now we will cover the spleen. In previous lecture we have covered the liver and all things about liver and important things. They are important surfaces, borders, markings, relations, all. Now next we will start the spleen. So for about spleen, it is look like this. Done. And it has borders, surfaces, and poles. Done. It is look like this. To about spleen, first take the hair, some important things like hairy Richter's number. What is hairy Richter's number? These are odd numbers like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, and 11. These are hairy Richter's number about spleen. What are the significance? One is the one centimeter is the thickness of spleen. Thickness of spleen is 1 centimeter. 3 centimeter is breadth. Breadth of spleen. Three centimeter. 5 centimeter is the length of spleen of Vesivala. Obviously, length of spleen. So, for remembering, these are the short trick. Hair Richter's number 5 cm. 7 is the weight, 7 ounce. Ounce of weight. Weight is 7 ounce. And 11 to 12 equal 11, 9 to 11 is the extension of rib. Location. Located between 9th to 11th rib. In 2 ribs ke beech mein hota hai. It is lying in between 2 ribs. So these are numbers. Position yaad kare to spleen, we know spleen present in posterior to stomach, like fundus region, relation to fundus region. So it is present in basically left hypochondrium region. Hypochondrium region. Present in hypochondrium region. Done. Basically hypochondrium region present hoti hai. And now after this now come to the surfaces of the spleen. Surfaces and borders. So spleen is also has 2 surfaces like liver. One is diaphragmatic surface, you know, it is present in posterior to posterior to stomach. So one surface is covered by diaphragm and another surface is which is near to stomach. One surface is against diaphragm and one surface is against stomach. So these surface is called visceral surfaces. Surfaces have 2 surfaces. One is again diaphragmatic, which is against to diaphragm, near to diaphragm. Diaphragmatic, and another is visceral surface, which is near to which organ? Stomach, pancreas, and jejunum, coil, etc. So these have two surfaces like this. It is look like this, slightly concave. Done. This surface is called this visceral surface. This is visceral, and this is diaphragmatic, which is against diaphragm. Done. These are two surfaces. Now borders. It has three borders and two ends. Remember, first cover the borders, then ends. Spleen has three borders. When we see the visceral surface of the spleen, so we can found three borders of the spleen. We draw the visceral surface first. So visceral surface of spleen is look like this. Done. Here has opening. One border is this. Another border is this. And one border is this. This is also extended border line. Done. So it has three borders. Similar things. It is superior, so it is called superior border. It is middle border, intermediate border or middle border, middle or intermediate. Border. And the last is, it is inferiorly, so it is called inferior border. Inferior border. Again, remember, superior border has some notches like this. So it is a markable feature of superior border, but may be absent also. These markings, notches may be absent, but they can help in differentiating superior and inferior border. Superior border, it has notches help in identification. Then next is their poles or ends. So it has two ends. Anterior and posterior, two ends basically. Anterior and posterior, same we draw. Ends mein anterior, one is anterior and another is posterior. Let's say ends. Anterior and posterior. Posterior. But important thing is anterior end is more like border. Let's say this is the example of spleen. This is called posterior end and this is called anterior end. This. It is much like border, but it is end. It more look like border. Look like border, but actually end. Done. And another is posterior. It is pointed. This is pointed. So these has two ends. It has two ends. Anterior end and posterior end. Posterior end is pointed. Anterior end is borderline. Anterior end posterior end. Done. These are some features of the screen. Their position, their findings, weight, location, all these. Now come to the splenic angle. Spleen, we know, spleen has some important relation with 10th rib. Important thing. Let's say we draw the posterior wall of the abdomen. So posteriorly we have vertebra, let's say this is vertebra and this is 10th rib, 11, this is 9, this is 10, this is 11. So we draw only 10th rib. We need 10th rib. We only draw 10th rib. This 10th rib. So spleen has important relation with 10th rib. Which spleen? A spleen is also on in axis with 10th rib. Like this. Let's say this 10th rib. So inside the spleen, because this is back wall, back of back side, posterior view, posterior view, we have ribs, then inside ribs we have spleen. Spleen is look like this. Inside rib. So axis of 10th rib is coincide with the axis of spleen. This angle is called this. And this angle is 45 degree angle of spleen. This is called angle of spleen. This is angle of spleen. 10th rib, it has coinciding axis of 10th rib and spleen, which is making 45 degree angle. Then, so this is angle of spleen. This is back. Posterior view. We take view from posterior side, back side, back posterior. So first rib and then inside rib we have spleen. Then note this. So now come to the relations of the spleen. Relations of spleen. We know diaphragmatic surface is completely covered by diaphragm. No, it is so. Diaphragmatic surface has not relations. Basically, we know only it is wholly covered by diaphragm. So we can write diaphragmatic surface covered by diaphragm. Just an important one relation is present in diaphragmatic surface which will cover diaphragm. First we draw the visceral surface of the spleen. So spleen is look like this. Done. This is a diagram of spleen, visceral surface. In posterior end we have diaphragmatic surface. This is visceral surface. We can write visceral surface of spleen. We know here is a first important thing is hilum present. A hilum present for entering and exit of vessels in spleen, lymphatics and all. This is superior border, this inferior border, this is intermediate border or middle border. Done. So first, this is superior border. इंटीरियर बॉर्डर, इसको एस की लिख देते हैं, एस बी, दिस इज सुपीरियर बॉर्डर, देन दिस इज इंफीरियर बॉर्डर आई डी, एंड दिस इज इंटरमीडिएट बॉर्डर, इंटरमीडिएट और मिडल बॉर्डर लिख देता हूं, इंटरमीडिएट पूरे लिख देता हूं मैं, इंटरमीडिएट बॉर्डर, डन। सो इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग वन इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन सुपीरियर बॉर्डर एंड इंटरमीडिएट बॉर्डर। वी हैव वन नॉच और वन इंप्रेशन विच इज द इंप्रेशन ऑफ विच स्टमक इंप्रेशन, फंडस ऑफ स्टमक, वी नो इट इज प्रेजेंट बिहाइंड द स्टमक, सो इट हैज इंप्रेशन फॉर स्टमक, दिस इज स्टमक इंप्रेशन। Stomach impression done, and in between intermediate border and inferior border we have kidney impression, basically renal impression, this is renal impression, this is renal impression, renal impression for kidney, for kidney, done, and just on intermediate border like this, this portion has impression for tail of pancreas, we know because pancreas extend posterior to stomach and go to the spleen, we know splenic artery also supply the pancreas through this, so pancreas tail also extend in spleen like this, it makes impression, so it is impression for tail of pancreas, impression for tail of pancreas, tail of pancreas, pancreas tail का impression है, and below pancreas is tail, this is called, this big impression, this impression is for impression for colon, colon का spleen flexure, we know last time we have covered this hepatic flexure, let's say this is colon, transverse colon, whole colon, so in right side this called hepatic colon, hepatic flexure, flexure, so and this portion is called which is near to spleen, so it is called splenic flexure, splenic flexure, basically impression of colon, transverse colon impression, just transverse colon impression, but important thing is it is not much like this, it is more prominent, it is like this, so it is more prominent flexure, impression this impression much more prominent than hepatic flexure, like this, this hepatic, this is splenic, splenic is more prominent, impression for splenic flexure of colon, splenic flexure of colon, then these are impressions on the spleen, intermediate border, all things. this is called hilum. Hilum means the part or defect where all blood vessels enter, exit from the spleen, like liver. Potipotentiary liver may like this. Hilum. Splenic arteries, splenic vein, lymphatics, nerves, all passes from in this. Then, so this is hilum portion. Come to the content of the hilum. Hilum content is what contents? Basically, splenic vein, splenic artery, will be first. Splenic artery, ciliate trunk se supply thi. Splenic artery. Then next will be splenic vein. Splenic vein. Another is lymphatics, few lymphatics. Lymphatic node, parabolic, pericolic splenic node, parabolic or pericolic splenic node, lymphatics, nodes basically. Parabolic, parapeotic, aortic nodes. Then, and nerves ho sakti hai, basically nerves, sympathetic, parasympathetic. Parasympathetic is again same from vagus, and sympathetic also present. Sympathetic again, sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. And vagus supply. Then these are the contents of the hilum. Sympathetic supply may be T7 to T12. T7 to T12. Then sympathetic supply. Then these are the contents of spleen. Now, one posterior relation of the spleen which is helping holding the spleen in its position in left hypochondrium region. There is a big ligament present which is extend from the diaphragmatic crus. Diaphragmatic crus of the diaphragm. Basically diaphragm extension. We know, let's say this is the diaphragm. This is the diaphragm. So diaphragm has two extension on vertebral column like this. One right and one left. Then, so these are called crus of diaphragm. Crus of diaphragm. Right and left crus of diaphragm. Then, so one ligament extend between from this to the which part which is not attached to the spleen but helps in holding the spleen in its position so that it cannot descend in the lower region. One ligament is which is ascend from here to the splenic flexure of the colon. Here is splenic flexure. Then, and spleen is present in front of this spleen, which is it holds the spleen basically like curtain, jhula type, just like carpet. So it is present like carpet for spleen. Spleen is present here. This ligament is called phrenicopolic. Phrenicopolic ligament. Because attached from diaphragm, diaphragm, we use the word phrenic. Phrenic. Diaphragm to colon. So it is called phrenicopolic ligament. which is in posterior relation of spleen. Posterior, basically diaphragmatic surface, posterior relation. Posterior relation of spleen. Done. Diaphragmatic crest to spleen colon. Okay. This is left. Basically mixtures of them. Both are not equivalent. The distance between not these two crests is not much like this. These are very few. Both light okay. But very less. Left crest and this is right crest. Right. Crest. Then it is just posterior relation which helping holding the spleen in left hypochondria, otherwise it descends. So it is protective relation. Now come to the blood supply of the spleen. First note this. Then now come to the blood supply of the spleen. Blood supply. So for blood supply we already know there is a artery which is called splenic artery, which is a branch of celiac trunk. Come here, and one is a branch of, one is a tributary of portal vein, which is a venous system of abdominal organs. It is again a tributary of portal vein. It also drains from spleen. So blood supply, let's say this is spleen. Artery is tortuous, called splenic artery. Arterial supply, artery, branch of branch of celiac trunk. We have covered this. Celiac trunk. Celiac trunk. And another is, which is a branch of, which is a tributary of portal vein. We know splenic vein in from niche se inferior mesenteric vein, both combined and then joined with superior mesenteric vein and form the portal vein like this. This is splenic vein. This is inferior mesenteric. This is superior mesenteric. Here it combine and form the portal vein. This is splenic vein for venous drainage of spleen. Splenic vein for venous drainage. This is inferior mesenteric. Mesenteric. Superior mesenteric. Mesenteric. And this is portal vein, which go in the liver. We already know. We have covered this in last lectures. Done. So this is for venous supply. Venous drainage. Venous drainage, and this is for arterial supply. Arterial supply. It also has, it also forms some ligaments. We know linear renal ligament, gastrosplenic ligament, already know. So first, according to arterial blood supply, we have two types of spleen. How? Let's say this is spleen. When splenic artery go, if it divide near to spleen like these vessels, divide into many tributaries. So this spleen is called compact spleen. compact spleen. And these are short splenic vessels. These are short branches of splenic artery. This is splenic artery. According to artery, splenic artery. And another is when, let's say this is again splenic artery, this is spleen. These vessels is now this end, it divide very initially and form long, long vessels. It form long, long branches of splenic artery. So these have long branches. So this is called diffuse spleen. Diffused spleen. These are two types of spleen. Types. Done. Types of spleen. According to arterial blood supply. Done. Next. We draw again the section near to spleen T12 level to understand some things. This is vertebra again. We know one is aorta, one is vena cava, posterior in posterior wall, and here is ribs present. First we draw the peritoneum of the stomach. Done. Peritoneum. This is again liver. Done. This is stomach. Near to stomach, we have this is spleen. And this is kidney. You know, kidney is retroperitoneal. So these are kidneys. Done. These are kidneys. But here some ligaments also form. This is gastrosplenic ligament. Done. And this is again, which is extend here for aorta. For aorta branch, basically splenic artery. Done. For this ligament, splenic from splenic trunk, splenic artery go in this ligament. Done. Splenorenal ligament. This ligament is splenorenal ligament and this is splenic artery. Done. Remember one thing, we know already, pancreas is also retroperitoneal. It is also present posterior to abdomen. So this, remember, this is the ligament. Which ligament? Bigger. This is ligament. And from here vessels enter. This is splenorenal ligament, linorenal ligament. Pancreas tail also extend in this segment. And another, whole pancreas is retroperitoneal, we already know. This is pancreas. This is pancreas. It is again retroperitoneally. But tail is extend in splenorenal ligament or linorenal ligament. And through this linorenal ligament, splenic artery also go. Done. First, we write splenorenal ligament content. Content means what? Basically, splenic vessels. We already know splenic vessels, arteries, veins. Done. And another is tail of the pancreas. Tail of pancreas is also contained. Done. So these are contents of this. And some again lymphatics and fat also present. These are the common things. We can write content in all everybody, everything. Lymphatics and some all things. Done? So these are the content of the splenorenal ligament, which is a lesion. And you know, this is gastrospleen ligament. Through this ligament, two branches of splenic artery also extend to the stomach. One is short gastric artery for which supply the fundus region, and another is left gastric omental artery, which is again branch of splenic artery, which go into the stomach, greater curvature, left side. Content of gastrospleen ligament, we already know. This is gastrospleen ligament, which is ligament between spleen and stomach. Gastro splenic ligament. Contents in the gastrum, short gastric arteries, which is both are branches of splenic artery for stomach supply, gastric vessels, and short gastric vessels and left omental. Gastric omental artery. Then, so these are the content of gastrospleen ligament. Here is one clinical case. The clinical case is splenectomy. Removal of spleen. But important thing is, for removing spleen, remember, if spleen is also present in peritoneum, and for spleen removal, we have to remove first strip in tail of the pancreas, because if during cutting of spleen, if we cut the tail of the pancreas, so we can, this called diabetes, because all islets of cells presenting tail. We have to care for tail of pancreas present in linear renal ligament. It can also cut linear renal ligament. So this is important clinical case. Another is splenic hemorrhage. Remember, splenic hemorrhage is most common hemorrhage or bleeding in the abdominal region. Splenic hemorrhage. First move this. So second case is splenic hemorrhage. Hemorrhage means rupturing of spleen, basically. Splenic rupture is most common. It is most common splenic bleeding in abdomen. Bleeding. Rupture of spleen. Most common organ in rupture. Most common organ ruptured during any trauma or injury. Then, नेक्स्ट इज स्प्लीनोमेगैली, मेगैली मींस साइज ऑफ स्प्लीन इंक्रीजेस, स्प्लीन साइज इंक्रीजेस, साइज इंक्रीजेस. Important thing is for this it is a can cause diabetes, diabetes mellitus, because deficiency of insulin occur. Diabetes mellitus. Diabetic mellitus. Because tail contain islets of Langerhans. Langerhans. Mostly islets of Langerhans cells present in tail of the femur. So it is most common case of diabetes. Most commonly cause diabetes. If splenic tumor occur irregularly. We cut the tail. Next, size of spleen increase here. But important thing, spleen is present in right left side, spleen sizing here. So it extends towards the right side. Basically, it extends to the right iliac fossa, right iliac segment. It starts extending towards extending towards right iliac region. Right iliac region. Then, because present in left side, it extend obliquely and going to the right side, like this. This extend like this. So it is also case, and from we know work of spleen, it is a graveyard of RBC. In every old sentence, RBC destroying here, graveyard for RBC. So if size of spleen or splenomegaly occur, spleen size increases, so more number of RBC then decreases, because more number of RBC fall here. So what happened? Anemia can also occur. This splenomegaly can cause anemia, because more number of RBC destroyed by this. RBC destruction with a normal function. RBC destruction. Here, more RBC destruction occurs, so can cause anemia. RBC destruction. RBC destruction occurs. Then RBC destruction occurs, which can cause anemia, hemolytic anemia basically. So it is a for anemia for splenomegaly it is also involved. These are some clinical cases of spleen. Note this. Then so here this is about the spleen. So here if we end the lecture next time, we will cover the another organ. Thank you.